If you're looking to buy a stacked NBA 2K account with max badges and more, visit sportstmb.com. He has been in the community for years and has hundreds of reviews. Click the first link in the description to get your account today.
Yo, so what is up, guys? It's JJ2K, and in today's video, I got you guys with the best VC glitch after patch 4. Yes, patch 4 has, like, just dropped. If you guys are just waking up, you guys are gonna see that they have fixed a couple things. Now, I do know a couple things have been fixed relating around glitches, but I can guarantee y'all this VC glitch still does work. You guys are gonna get around 30,000 VC an hour base minimum if you guys really take advantage of this and grind this method. So, I'm just here to say, bro, if you guys are new to my channel and are a returning subscriber, the only thing you guys need to do before we attempt this glitch is to like the video, bro. That is the easiest way to show support, and it also helps me to know what I should be posting on my channel. Let's try to hit 500 likes in today's video. I know that's a really easy goal, and I always set it because that should be the base standard, because enough of you guys watch the videos where at least you guys can just smash that like button. So just know, bro, this works for both consoles, and as well, it has nothing to do with a USB or online storage. I've done enough talking though. Hopefully you guys do enjoy the video. Let's just hop straight into this VC glitch, y'all. Alright, so now we're gonna hop right into the My Career screen, and in this glitch, we're gonna be making a new player. Now, the key in this is to make him as crappy as possible, right? He needs to be a point guard because this is gonna make things a lot easier once we get into the second step. So, like I said earlier, the pie chart doesn't matter, your attributes don't matter. The only thing that really matters is make your dude 5'7". This is gonna make it a lot easier for this to actually work. You guys are gonna understand it in a little bit, but like I said, don't worry about any of the physicals, don't worry about the attributes, just get through this as quick as possible. So once you guys have sped through your My Career creation, we're just gonna wanna hit Start My Career, and now we're gonna head straight into the NBA. Now follow along here, because you guys could mess this up as well. So obviously this is a VC glitch, right? So we're trying to get as much VC as possible to start this glitch, because what is the point if we're getting 400 VC a game trying to do this glitch? There's literally no reason. So again, the first part of this, you guys are going to want to go to the crappiest team in the NBA, preferably like the Cavaliers, the Pistons. For example, I picked the Pistons. Now from here, we are going to want to sim to the end of the season. Reason being is you guys start out whenever you go to the NBA without playing through college and high school, you guys start out on a 400 VC contract. Now again, like I said earlier, what is the reason to do a VC glitch if you're only getting 400 VC for every time you redo this glitch? There's literally no reason. So this is the reason why you guys want to sim to the end of the playoffs, and hopefully, I know in some cases you can make the playoffs. This will not work if you make the playoffs. That is why I'm suggesting going to the Pistons, and since you made your players so bad, there is no way that you're gonna help aid that team. You guys are 5'7". You have the size of the average male. You're gonna get dunked on. Like, there's no way you're not doing anything, is what I'm trying to say. So from there, once you guys have simmed the season, this is gonna be another crucial step in doing this glitch. Now follow along. So again, like I said, there's no reason to be playing on a 400 VC contract. So what we're going to want to do next is enter in free agency, okay? So this is crucial again. So once we enter into free agency, the team that we pick really doesn't matter. At least I think so, it doesn't matter. So the team we go to, for example, I went to the Lakers. You guys are going to see it in 1 second. Every single team, because you're so bad, is going to offer you the same exact contract, the same exact minutes, the same exact everything. So this really doesn't matter as much, but let me just say that you guys, no matter what team you want to go to, you can get the same amount of VC from each team. So don't even think just because it's a bad team you're going to get more, because that's not how it works at all. What I'm going to suggest, just do what I do. Unless you guys are trying to finagle for some more VC, it's up to you guys, to be honest. But I know what worked for me. So you guys are about to see every single team in the NBA offered me 400 VC flat. So for my example, I go to the Lakers. Now, the first offer you're going to have to give them, you're going to have to turn down everything except for your VC. So turn down your teammate grade and also turn down your year. And then from there, bump that VC up to like 800 to 900 VC a game. Listen, this is negotiating 101 here in JJ's classroom. Now, like I said, they're going to offer a counter offer, and they're offering already 725. Now, you're not going to want to accept that. You're going to offer like 785 to 790. And this is when you guys can try to get as much VC as possible. I asked for 775, and they're going to accept it. I could have gotten like 780, but again, 5 VC does not matter to me for the sake of the video. So this is one of the exact reasons why I said you guys need to watch the video through, or you guys are going to miss something. I just nearly doubled your VC count a game, and this is going to make you double the VC guarantee that someone that didn't watch that part of the video would make. Okay, so now one thing you guys want to keep track of, okay? So now we're going to go to stats and go to the My Minutes tab. This is going to tell you how much minutes you guys have per game on your rotation. So you guys are automatically going to start out at 10 because you guys are such a bad prospect. This is good, but we're going to want to lower that even more. So this comes into the next part of this method. So for the very first two games, what we're going to want to do is be completely terrible. And like what I mean by that, you guys need to have like 8 turnovers, like 0 for 5, and then we're going to want to foul out, okay? So for both of these games, like I said, we're just going to want to get as bad of a teammate grade as possible. The F teammate grade is the biggest part about this. You need to have an F, you need to foul out, and you guys need to get a ton of turnovers, because the whole reason why we're setting this up to be this bad is the whole premise of why this glitch works. And I get it's a lot of effort up front. Obviously, you got to play like 2 games. It's like 5 minutes each game. It's low-key like 10 minutes of effort just to set it up. But like I said, this is the more extreme version of this VC glitch. But listen, this is a lot of VC once you do set it up. So like I said, these first 2 games, play as bad as possible, get an F grade, get a bunch of turnovers, and then foul out. The first 2 games do not matter. You're not going to get VC regardless, so don't even like worry about that aspect of it. So this is what you guys are going to see after the first game, that you just be completely terrible. You're just going to get no stats. You're going to get nothing to badges. You're going to get no VC earned. It's all good. It is a part of this glitch. So don't worry. This a little bit of wasted time is worth the effort in the long run, because it's going to grant you guys thousands and thousands of VC afterwards. So the next thing we're going to want to do after the first game is over, you guys want to go back to stats and then check your minutes. Normally, it's not going to change after the first game, but there might be a possibility if you suck that bad, it might get lower the first game. Okay, so once you guys load into the second game again, we're just going to repeat the process. We're just going to catch that ball and run out of bounds about like 6 or 7 times, take a couple bad shots, and then from there, we're going to let it end. Okay, so I'm just going to simulate through this one period, because by now you guys understand the process. I don't got to go in depth about the second game. It's as simple as the first game. Just suck, okay? Just literally suck, all right? All right, so hopefully now that you guys are at this part of the video, you guys are through your first 2 games. Hopefully you guys paused and then just waited for this to end to be able to match up with me. But like I said, you get your second game, and now this is when you guys are going to want to go to your stats, check out your minutes, and see if you guys are finally at that illustrious 5 minutes and the 12th man. Now that we are at 5 minutes and we are the 12th man, this is where we're going to want to start the actual method. So now that we are ready to do this glitch, we're going to have 5 minutes played. We're going to put that puppy on Hall of Fame difficulty. Now you guys are going to ask, yo, what about this actually makes it a glitch? Listen, the whole premise was to get as least minutes as possible and then go from there, because now we have 5 minutes inside of the game that we have to play, and you're not even going to have to play 5 minutes. Listen, what you guys need to do though, you need to suck again, but listen, you're not going to suck as hard, all right? Pause. All right, hold up. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You guys get my point. Hold up. Nah. Well, yeah, nah, you guys get my point. In this third game and from every single game onward doing this glitch, you guys do not want to have a good game, because that means your minutes will be boosted. Don't worry. All you guys got to do is get a couple turnovers and then start grabbing some fouls. It's literally going to take you guys 2 minutes to play a game. You're going to have to play 2 in-game minutes per every NBA game now that I set you guys up with this top-tier VC glitch. So you guys are going to see how quick it's going to take me to get subbed out once I start grabbing fouls. Because honestly, it takes about 2 minutes of in-game. I look at my minutes in this gameplay, I remember, and it says I only played 2 minutes. So like I said, once you start grabbing your first 2 fouls, it's going to put you into the second quarter. Now once you guys already have a couple turnovers, every time you guys touch the ball, I would recommend getting a turnover. Because anytime you touch it, it's just going to be a higher percentile chance of you guys actually getting subbed out. But like I said, if you guys don't get subbed out, there's no reason to panic, because every time that they touch the ball, you're just going to foul them. You're going to make it very easy and very simple. Once you guys do foul, it's going to be as simple as getting subbed in the game and then getting subbed out the moment you come back in the game. You guys see me grabbing like 6 or 7 turnovers, because in this gameplay, while I was trying to finish this glitch, I was also trying to see if you guys could honestly get 0 minutes played. But to be honest, it is very unfortunate. I don't think you can, even though I've seen a video on it. I'm pretty sure it got patched. So now that you guys have grabbed 4 or 5 fouls, it is around halftime. So now you guys aren't gonna panic, because it is simple as having 4 fouls. If you guys did it right, you foul again, and now you're gonna get put in the game with 17 seconds left, all right? And this is the bread and butter of the glitch, because we've honestly played about 2 minutes in game. Like, it took about 2 minutes to get around 800 VC. So in comparison, this is kind of close to the blacktop method, before the patch. You guys get around 800 VC every single 2 minutes. If you guys get good at it, I'm sure you could cut off some time, shave some time. But regardless, you guys get about 30k VC an hour. If you guys did enjoy this new VC glitch, like I said, new VC glitch, don't worry. It's going to get uploaded 100 times. So you guys might as well do it before it gets patched, because we know once this gets uploaded, 1,000 other guys are going to upload it acting like they came up with it. But it's whatever, dude. If you guys did enjoy the video, make sure to leave a like and as well as subscribe for future content. Bro, it's been your boy JJ2K. I am out. Peace.